All right, so what happens when you graduate engineering school? What are the paths that engineers usually take after they graduate engineering school and they are a couple of years on the field? And I was speaking with my friend, Alexis Karambot. If you haven't seen that interview with her, or the conversation that I had with her, I highly encourage you to go check it out. And also had a conversation with a new friend, Miguel Quinn. Also, he's a software engineer. So I started noticing some patterns and some common paths per se that engineers take when they after they graduate engineering school, and some of them may fit you, some of them you may be interested in, but I wanted to point them out. And there are four paths that engineers usually take after they graduate engineering school. But if the path that you are taking now or that you are planning on taking is not listed, please let me know in the comments below. I would really love to know. And so there's a couple of things to mention. First, if you are new to the channel, welcome. My name is Alex Isidro, and here we talk about engineering career and life analysis. And in this video, I'm going to give you four paths that engineers usually take, regardless of which engineering field you're part of. Number one, the first one is they remain as engineers, and they go from an engineer 1, 2, 3, and then they become senior engineers. And a lot of times that's where they kind of stop. They love the technical work that they do, and they remain there. Sometimes they even want to be senior engineers, because sometimes for them, it just becomes like too much of a hassle, right? Depending on the company that you work for, a senior engineering position may require different duties and whatnot. Obviously, at some point, if you have a lot of years of experience, you will be training or mentoring young engineers. But my point is that the first path is when you remain as an engineer and you still do the technical work 10, 20, 30, 40 years into your career. And this is, in my opinion, the engineers that just really, really love the work they do. They love crunching numbers, and they love the drawings, and they love modeling, and they just really love figuring things out from a technical perspective. Because when you start moving up from managers, and this is actually going to be the second path that I'm going to be mentioning here, the second path is when you go up the ladder and you become a manager, or you become a engineering manager, for redundancy, become an engineering manager, or perhaps you become a professional engineer, you get your license. Especially when you're a civil engineer, it's pretty common. Also, when you start becoming an engineering director or a project manager even, right? When you start going up the ladder of a certain company and you start being a little more involved, dealing directly with customers and managing people or leading people, and you start attending more meetings, you start being a little more, let's say, bothered or annoyed by doing like administrative stuff, like keeping timesheets and all this stuff. But that's like kind of like extra duties, but mainly you start dealing with a little higher level information, not just doing pure technical detailed work. So that's the second path that I wanted to mention here. The third path that I personally noticed in the 9 years of experience on the field is that you open your own company. After a couple of years on the field, after you kind of get a groove of what's happening, you get your license, perhaps you work under a professional engineer for a couple of years, if that's your thing, or maybe you work for a big company and you start learning code, or you start learning different technical skills that really help you dialing into one specific field, and you become an expert per se, and you say, you know what, I'm tired of working for a certain company and I'm gonna open my own. I'm gonna provide Alex Isidro technical services, right? There you go. That's a business, and I open it and I start marketing it, and then I start providing service or products to other people. Of course, also another way to open your company is when you provide a product, you develop it and you innovate and you solve some type of problem that is going to help make people's lives a little better, or a certain industry and whatever it happens to be. So the third path right there is opening your own company. And I think that this is one of the most common ones, or something that people really want to end up doing in the long term. But hey, it's not really for everyone, you know. And if you really like working for others and just going and doing your 8 hours of work, and then you're good and you just don't want to worry about anything else, because really entrepreneurship is not for everyone. Let's face it. It's nothing wrong with that. If you like it, if you enjoy it, and if it brings you satisfaction and you have autonomy and you're an expert at it and you really like it. And obviously also if you get paid well, by all means, do it. Keep doing it. So those are the first three so far. Remaining as an engineer, you go up the ladder, you open your own company. And the fourth one, and the last one that I want to mention here, is you switch careers. And this is obviously when you become a YouTuber, or perhaps you have your own podcast, or perhaps even you become a teacher. I actually have a friend who she was a, I want to say she was a biomedical engineer. She graduated from Virginia Tech as well. She had a really good job with Northrop Grumman, but then she hated it. She really did not like the engineering industry. She didn't like the crowd. And so she ended up moving somewhere else and she became a teacher. And now she really, really enjoys it. And so it's one of those things that once you hit the engineering industry, and if you really don't like it, don't feel like you're just pressured, and then don't feel like you have to remain in that industry, you know? And to be completely honest with you, I think the best time to transition careers in order to minimize the amount of the perhaps a pay cut that you get, it's in the early stages, the first two, three years of your career. That's the time when I personally think it's the best time, because after 2, 3, 4 years, your salary starts going up. It starts going up because you start staying longer in your field. Obviously, you start getting more experience and you start getting more valuable and people pay you more. However, if you are planning on switching careers, then the delta or the difference or the pay cut that you may experience or that you will experience when you switch careers, when you were getting paid, let's say, $50,000 and you switch to another career that pays you $40,000, that $10,000 is really not that bad, you know. But if you're 10, 15 years in engineering and then you are making $130,000, $150,000 a year and you want to switch careers, and you switch to a career that's going to pay you $40,000 a year, that's going to be a huge, much greater and more painful pay cut that you're going to experience. And that, I think, deters a lot of people. But the bottom line here is that there are other careers out there that engineers may be into. You know, like maybe you want to open your own podcast and then just talk about engineering there. And that's kind of like a subtle way to leverage all the knowledge and wisdom that you have and then share it with others that will find it useful coming behind, you know, like the younger engineers like you guys. And so, yeah, so those are the four main paths that I personally noticed that engineers take. Obviously, the broadest one is switching careers. You can go from engineering to like many other fields. And I think that you can leverage a lot of the math and science that you learn into other areas as well. And so there you go. You remain as an engineer. You go up the ladder. You open your own company, or you completely switch careers, or you somewhat switch careers, but you start trying different things. But the bottom line here, guys, is like something that I want you to take away from this video is to never remain stagnant. I think that one of the things, even if you remain as an engineer for years, you're still learning new things. You're still learning to optimize whatever you're working on. You start getting an expert. And so I think that the key in any of these paths is the growth and the progress that we make when we expand our knowledge, when we grow mentally, when we expand our knowledge for lack for redundancy. And so I just wanted to bring that up to your attention, and that education is going to help you go a long way. And so always keep growing, never stop learning, because if you stop learning and you stay stagnant, you're going to fall behind, you're going to disappear and fade away in the universe, and you're not going to really find life that interesting if you're not learning new things. So let me know in the comments below what you think, if you find or if you ever notice, if you're someone that has been on the engineering field for a long time, let me know in the comments below what other paths engineers take after graduation. And so with that being said, thank you guys for watching. Thank you for being here. Give it a damn like, consider subscribing, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.